Hello everyone, Francesco here, Frank for Friends. We are here again. NPM is getting quite a beating this week. If Shai Hulud wasn't sufficient, link in the comment for more detail about that. If you haven't heard the story or if you have been sleeping under a rock, there is more comments around what is happening on NPM. But today we have a perfect 10 on couple of tiny bit important library that's kind of power all the web system around the world. So we have two library and two vulnerability being compromised with fairly large amount of download, 36,700,000 React server and Next.js that are basically the heart of everything that you do with NPM and JavaScript. And as you can see, there are quite a number of downloads. Of course, the main distribution, the React part, and the Next are the heart of every web application that get built right now. And then you have also other partial one. Now, why this is particularly bad? Well, first of all, it's like Log4j. A remote code execution means something that can get triggered from an attack randomly by just executing a command or sending a specific string that the parser on the web server interprets, ingests, and breaks and escalate privilege. Those escalation of privilege don't require authentication. And this is why this is particularly bad, because an attacker could potentially trigger something malicious with just a string. And that's why this particular vulnerability got scored with perfect 10. Now, if we look into the detail, and I've created a tiny notebook LM so that we can go through it. It's a fantastic tool if you haven't seen, but it can summarize quite nicely, quite easily, a lot of this type of attacks. There is, of course, the discovery, the exfiltration, the lateral movement, the exploitation of the server. And as I mentioned, the main component have tons of downloads. You can see more detail on the website and which particular version is affected. Quite a number of them. Now, we have also released a scanner with some of the sample versions that are vulnerable and clean so that you can extract and determine which version is particularly vulnerable. I'm going to put the link in GitHub, but you can also see how to lock and freeze an update in case you want to upgrade and in case you want to avoid, like Shai Hulud, kind of getting compromised. Now, what is the timeline of the effects? On the 29th, we got notification from Bug Bounty Hunter of this exploit. Meta confirmed that is the maintainer of this particular set of libraries. The fix was created, published, and then the two vulnerability, the 55182 and the 66478, got published by the MVD. Now, why this is bad? Because an attacker can simply send an issue from a public server, deserialize the flight payload, and that's why flight night or fright night and the game of the campaign and the game of word in the campaign, escalate the vulnerability, break the container or the container boundaries, and then gain persistence, compromisation, and go forward. Now, what can you do if you have these particular vulnerabilities? Well, first of all, prioritize the one that are externally facing, because there are tons of downloads for this and tons of cloud affected instances. So if you can't patch this particular vulnerability, it's easier to put a WAF through. And on the web, at the very end, you can see the presence, but also you can see the WAF rule with observation rules or stopping rule, blocking rule. Now, this WAF particular rule were suggested as well from AWS in the document that I've shared. There are some more specific WAF rule for both AWS and Google Cloud Armor. So you can get both of them on the article. Now, some additional consideration, because this is usually a vulnerability, in a particular library, it's important to consider as well which container run this particular library, which of these containers are exposed over the web. This is supposed to be a web browser and the web, and mitigate this first with either a WAF, that is supposed to be a WAF, but in general, prioritize the ones that are exposed externally versus not exposed externally. And that's one of the things that we can help with Phoenix to fix, identify, and prioritize. So in the end, what can you do? First of all, identify if you're vulnerable. There is a GitHub. There is a GitHub link that you can run and check if the vulnerability are present. With Phoenix, you can upload those vulnerabilities directly using the script, launch one of our campaigns, get the remediation done, and upgrade every version, prioritizing, of course, the one on systems that are externally facing versus systems that are more internally facing. And second of all, apply the role from a WAF perspective on both AWS or Google Cloud Armor. So NPM are getting attack up, down, left, and right. Reaction and fast reaction is probably the best advice that I can give. And monitoring this kind of situation, reacting very quickly, and identifying malware like Shai Hulud, Log4j, or, well, Log4j is not on NPM, but the NPM as a system are being targeted. I believe that, like Shai Hulud, this is a probe of the ecosystem as a whole, and is not the last one that we're going to see, because the system is failing consistently, and it is a little bit by nature that everybody can publish anything, so... But this is a particular fragile system, because it is deployed everywhere, and the reaction on this vulnerability was quite immediate, and we haven't seen any major case so far. And I'm recording on the 4th of December. We haven't seen any major escalation on this vulnerability. So fix it before it becomes dangerous. It's quite easy to exploit, so it's a single string exploitation. There are some GitHub out there with some POC, but we haven't seen an exploit in the wild. So fix it before it becomes dangerous. Stay safe out there. This is Francesco Cipollone or Franco Friend with Phoenix Security. Check the document and stay safe out there. Goodbye.